Hello everybody, today is day 7 of Make a Video in 2-Hour Challenge, and today I'm going to go over an introduction to music. Let's get started. What is music? Music is the art of sound generation, such that a pattern of tones is created, which may elicit an emotional response from the conditioned listener. So, lot to unpack here. First of all, it is the art of sound generation. Okay. Pretty much anything could be music at this point, right? If I take these two pencils and I tap them together, does that make music? Well, it is such that a pattern of tones is created. So right there, that's a tone. That impact, that could be a tone. It is created, which may elicit an emotional response from the conditioned listener. So. Was that music? Well, did it elicit an emotional response? Are you conditioned to understand that as music? Was that rhythm? Rhythm is one element of music, as we'll see later. But anyway, what is conditioning? Conditioning is the psychological programming of an individual's response to a signal, sensorial, conditional, or informational, or social. So, why do I include this element of conditioning? Well, in order for you to interpret something as music, you have to be conditioned to understand that it is music. Some elements, some types of music, for instance, what entire cultures will take as being the standard of music, take some elements of Asian music, Thai music, and to a Western ear, it sounds almost like a cacophony, like what is going on here? But if you've been conditioned to understand this style of music, you understand it and you're able to categorize it and have the proper response. So therefore, the listener's environmental history will determine what is considered music versus mere noise. Okay, so that is music, the art of sound generation. Okay, now we're going to move on from there. Just a brief introduction, as I said, and we're going to get into transcription. What is musical transcription? Well, I don't have that much familiarity with other systems or styles of music. All I know is the Western style of notation, and this is where musical patterns are transcribed on a staff, plural staves. So the staff is 5 parallel lines on which symbols and text are placed to indicate the primitive elements of music. Primitive elements of music. So what are these? They are timing, the duration and spacing of tone generation, pitch, and in the context of Western music, pitch is one of 12 basic tones with its variants. So we call those octaves, right? The sound, and a pitch is actually a sound frequency measured in hertz. This is the number of sinusoidal cycles per second. I can actually show you on this keyboard right here. We'll get into pitch, because timing is just how quickly or for how long a particular tone is being created. So let me go ahead and I'm going to pull up two things, actually. One of them is this frequency chart provided by MIT. And we'll go through some of these. So on a piano, we have, let's see, I can use my keyboard here. So here is middle C, C4. Okay. Indicated by the little red dot. On this chart, we have C4. Notice the numbers start at 0. 0 is C0 is 16.35 hertz. And we go all the way up. Notice here's C0. Then we go to C1, C2, C3, and C4. Notice these are all essentially, they are just variations of each other, which is why I said that in Western music, music is made up of 12 tones and just then the variations of those 12 tones. So if we take a look at C4, C4 has a hertz value of 261.63 hertz, so that's Hz, and so on our keyboard here, so that would be roughly 261, right? 261.63 hertz. And then what's known as concert A, which is C4, right here, and I believe, I don't know on the key. There we go. So on the keyboard, that's that right there. That is concert A, and that is given as A4. And we see here that A4 is 440 hertz. 440 hertz. Okay, so those are notes, the 12. Remember, all of music is made of 12 tones and their variants, and those tones are frequencies. Okay, so let's go back to music, the notes. So those tones, those are pitches, so 12 pitches total in total. So we see here the example, concert A, 440 hertz. So we've covered timing. Timing is the duration and spacing of tone generation. Pitch, timbre. Now timbre is interesting because it's the subjective quality of the tone, whether it's bright or sweet, harsh or powerful. So for instance, you have a French horn. A French horn is a powerful yet sweet sound. A piccolo, bright and joyful. A clarinet is it has a particular sweetness to it, but a mournfulness. So these are examples of timbre, the subjective quality of the tone, and it will be different for different people. Now then we then move into expression. This is the method of sound execution, whether it's sudden attacks or sustained and connected tones, the expression, the way that sound is executed. So the notation is written in such a way that the basic elements of music are presented in as an exact manner as the system will allow, okay? And those elements include melody, harmony, and rhythm. And so I'm going to go ahead and show you a staff so you understand what's going on here. So right now, we don't know exactly, we have no way of determining where, if I were to write a particular note on here, you would have no idea of knowing what is this thing, what am I trying to convey. So in order to convey some sort of pertinent information, I first have to determine the pitch. And pitch is determined by the sign. This is the treble clef, and this turns the staff into what's known as a clef. This is treble clef now. Treble clef means that, as we saw before, C4 is this note on the staff. So this is C4. And I think I'll probably have to get rid of some of these notes here so I have more room. Oh, delete. There we go. So this is C4. This would be D4, E4, and I'll stop at F4. So you see on our keyboard, where is it here? Keyboard. Did I lose it? Oh, there it is. Okay. So on the keyboard, that would be C4, D4, E4, and F4. So those are the first four notes in it's the reason why they're numbered that way is because you start the numbering 0 up through, what is it, on the frequency chart. How high did they go? They go up to B8. And those are relative to the piano. On a piano keyboard, and this one we can't really zoom out, but if I were to show you another piano, which I'm not going to right now, but your lowest pitch that you can go is C0. That's your lowest C note on your piano, and then you jump up, so C0, C1, C2, C3, C4, and C4 happens to be what is known as middle C. Okay. So that would be how you could demonstrate, this would be pitch, and then if I wanted to demonstrate timing or rhythm, then you have different values. You have what's known as your whole note. This has no what's called a stem. This value is a half note. This value filled in would be a quarter note. A tail is an eighth note. Notice, so this one is whole. This would be a value of one. This is a value of one half. This is a value of one quarter. 1/8. 1/16. And finally, you also have 1/32, but I'm not going to worry about that. So 1/32 and 1/64 even. Sometimes you have four. But you see each of these tails. I know that's pretty difficult to see, but maybe if I zoom in, could I do it? Could I do it properly? So three tails would be a 1/32. Now, these are all relative, okay? So this is simply saying, once you have determined what your whole note stands for, then each of those is going to be half that value, progressively smaller and smaller, okay? And then, of course, so that is your rhythm. I'm not going to talk about dots or anything like that or rests. But anyway, this is how you would differentiate your tonal length, okay, according to rhythm. And so finally, we get back to what are the three elements of music? There we go. So the three elements of music are melody. Now, you'll see a lot of lists all over the place and say, what are the elements of music? And they'll say, well, things like pitch. In fact, even earlier, where I've got timbre and expression, I have those associated with tonal expression because those are the way that a tone is created. Okay, so these three, melody, harmony, and rhythm, are like the meta elements of music. This is taking into consideration things like expression dynamics. And so we take a look at what is melody. Melody is a recognizable tonal pattern derived from the interaction of pitch and rhythm. So you take these two elements, pitch and timing, I should say timing, but you take those two elements, you combine them, and you create patterns from those, and that's where you get your melodies. So on the keyboard, for instance, let's see if I can pick one out. So that's just, you know, that's probably not very recognizable. I just made it up. Let's see if I can, where's C here? Was it I on my keyboard? Right? So, melody, twinkle, twinkle, little star, right? So this, that is example of melody. And notice, it was the interaction of pitch and rhythm. So, short, 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 dum, dum, bum, 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 bum. So, short, 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 long, short, 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 long. And then a little break in between. So notice interaction of timing and rhythm to create a melody. Timing, rhythm, and pitch. And then harmony. This is where you take multi-tonal interaction, and it's interpreted according to the science of acoustics and subjective experience. So there are elements to harmony where they make sense. For instance, and they come from nature. If I have this note here, for instance, a fifth is one of those fundamental values that is created by the science of acoustics itself. A fifth is always present in music. And then we can also, an octave. An octave is also present in music. In fact, all of these tones, they can be derived using the overtones, which I'm not going to talk about here, but so the interactions between these two tones, they do exist. It might be somewhat faint, but they do exist in nature. So by playing them together, I'm merely reinforcing what is already there. And from that, you have the basis for harmony. And then, of course, I can build harmonies. This would be your major chord, right? A minor chord. Those are harmonies. It's the interaction of tones. So there's one. Major, and then, so that would be what's called an inversion, but that's a minor chord. And then if I wanted, I could then, so once again, I need C. There we go. So that would be an example of harmony. And finally, we have rhythm. Now, rhythm was, we already had that up here with timing, but rhythm is the predictable timing of sound, okay? So it's these occurrences, melody and harmony, within the space of time itself. And those are the three basic elements of music. And so, as we saw here on the staff, that all of music is built, at least in Western notation, is built on a staff. So, like, for instance, if I wanted to write Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. Oh. Am I doing that? There we go. Okay. So, Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. We first have to determine where it are. No, just kidding. I have to determine the length of the note. So, I'm going to decide that I'm going to build it off of what's called a quarter note. Okay. So, and it starts on C, right? So this is middle C. C. So there we go. C. C. G. G. A. 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 G. Now notice I'm leaving this open because now that's a half note. So a quarter note, half note. A. So C, C, G, G, A, G. And then F. F, F, E, E. D. D. C. And once again, half note. So this is a transcription of that melody, Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. And so on and so forth. But anyway, that is the basics of notation in the Western system. All right, and as you see here, let me go back to my lecture notes. I have included at the bottom of the notes some of the resources that might be useful. So the keyboard that I'm using, it comes from the onlinepianist.com sheet music. This is music that you can print off. So let me go ahead and show you that here. So the music that I printed off there, additional info, there we go. So this is blanksheetmusic.net, and this allows you to build out all sorts of blank sheet music and then print that blank sheet music for you to then fill in so you can practice writing notes, some composition as well. So that is blank sheet music. Let's see what else. And then a good resource if you want to see scores, you can go to IMSLIP, International Music Library. And let me go ahead and show you that. Pull that up over here. There we go. So this is IMSLIP. IMSLIP, it's the international, what does it say? I don't see what the acronym stands for. But on here, you can look for any score. So let's say we want to look at some Bach. Excuse me. There we go. So category Bach. So here is Bach. Alternative name, transliterations, and so let's go through. Let's look for some of his music. Let's see. We want his compositions. And ach bleib ein uns Herr Jesu Christ. So this is a complete recording. We don't need the recordings. We need the complete scores. So I'm going to go ahead and look here. And if you want to support them, then you can go ahead and become a member, and then you don't have to wait for this. I accept and continue to download the file. This is an organ score. Notice there are the two manuals. This is what's called a bass clef. This is a tenor clef, and this is treble clef, tenor clef, bass clef. See that? So that is an example of a score. So you see here. Here are some examples of some notes. This is our quarter. That's our half note, a quarter note rest, quarter note. That's our timing. This is called common time, which means in 2-2 time. These are accidentals. So you see, as we go through, we'll uncover more and more of the parts of notation. But this is a great place if you want to look at various scores. And just get an idea of how music is written. Okay, thank you very much for watching. Let's see here. Is there anything else that I needed to cover in my notes? Additional info, let's go to music. Let's see here. Oh, yes, the pitch frequency chart. I got that from MIT, actually, I believe. But anyway, yeah, it's just a chart, and it can be useful if you're, let's say you're playing around with tone generation and you want to create pitched tones, then you can use that chart and you will get the correct sounds. And then all of this information, the notes from this particular video, as well as some other documents, will be found on my GitHub music repository. All right, thank you very much for watching. This has been day 7 of Create a Video in 2-Hour Challenge. I hope you enjoyed. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.